concept of the Perlin II aircraft is to be a purpose-built glider, a specially designed glider, that its main feature is that it's pressurized, that the crew can go to very high altitude without having to wear spacesuits, without having to wear pressure suits.
Well, first of all, as I said, it's a fascinating project. It's a fascination of flight. And then I heard that they want to bring up a glider to something like 90,000 feet. I first couldn't believe it.
On February 28th, we had the very first pressurized flight of the Perlin II. The hardest technical problem was building a glider that would be light in weight and could be sealed up like the space station. At above about 48 or 9,000 feet, breathing pure oxygen isn't enough to keep us alive. Above 60,000 feet, the pressure is low enough that your blood would boil.
We have, you know, an aeronautic company, but also a space company. And this project fits kind of in between. It's an aeronautic project, no doubt, but it's operating at the edge of space, doing something that hardly anybody would probably have believed possible. We still believe that the only way we stay competitive, to stay at the edge of technology, is to invest also into innovation. So it fits perfectly our interest in breaking new grounds in innovation, in aeronautic, as well as in space. And if we can have a little science around that, then if that's a project that is inspiring for kids and teachers to fire up the next generation of great engineers and explorers, all the better.